Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Brandon Cavalakis, and this is Grim Dawn. I just want to go over one thing. My devotion points are glitched out. I got all 28 in the first difficulty, and it only says I have 22 for some reason. It didn't record six of them. So, can any of you tell me why? It's just weird. I'm always encountering glitches, and I don't know why, and it's just weird. I got all 28. I got the Shrine of Mokdragon. I got the Esther Karn Valley, the Tomb of Bartholomew, because the friend teleported me in there because I didn't pick a faction. I got the Foggy Bank that I was missing. I got so many. I got a ton of them that I missed, and yeah, I got Viper maxed out here. I got some into Behemoth here. That's pretty cool. And then I'll get Lizard, and then once I get Lizard, I'll be able to get this. Well, I have to get three more points. I have to get one into the Chaos Road again, and then I'll be able to get into Dying God, which is going to be very good, especially once I get my Obsidian Juggernaut. I might even get over here. I might get the Widow. I might. It seems pretty useful to me anyway. I'm probably going to get Empty Throne eventually. Anyway, we're gonna go and we're gonna kill Vilith today, and then we're gonna go up to the cave. We might even go all the way up to the village, honestly, if there's time. Depends on how long it takes me to kill Vilith and everything, you know? You know? Damage is crazy now with Kraken. Look at that, 15.7k. It's insane. And I'm only level 53, and I'm not even that geared at all. But I did get an Impervious Scaleless Ring when I was doing the Den of the Lost, so Pierce resistance went up by quite a good bit. So did my lightning. I don't have that good resistances at all. I do need to work on those, but that requires augments, which that requires a lot of reputation, which I do not have right now, sadly. I will definitely get it eventually, as you're going to need augments and you're going to need everything to help you out in the beginning. But as you can see, I'm just wrecking the hell out of things. The damage I do is pretty damn insane, hitting over 11,000 on average, it seems. I did forget to put away a lot of my components, pretty much all of them. I can do that off camera if I remember. I have a dentist appointment in another hour or so this has got to be not that long of a video, which is why I'm a little bit time constrained right now, and you know I can't do it like when everyone's home, because then it's loud as all hell, and it's annoying to record when everyone's home, or just anyone is home, really. So yeah, anyway, let's just move on. I really hate those harbingers, the Chthonian harbingers. They really, really hurt, like, seriously. They are such a pain in the ass. They blow up when they die, and they do so much damage, and they put that curse on you that breaks your strength and breaks your resistances, and it's just ridiculous. They're really, really, I wouldn't say overpowered, but I would just say really, really hard to deal with. Especially as a melee. Hell, even as a range, if you're semi-ranged, then like you're not that far away from them, their radius is actually quite huge. You will get hit by them, even if you're at semi-range. You need to be pretty far away to not get hit by the explosion. And even when I'm far away, I sometimes somehow get hit. I don't know how or why, but I sometimes just get hit anyway. It's weird, but whatever. Anyway, Vilith is over here, and oh, there's no shrine in Elite. Did not know that. Couldn't remember. I'm not good with remembering shrines at all. I'm gonna nullify my poison that I had on me. Alright, a Praetorian Face Guard. I believe I already had one of those. I believe. Yeah, it definitely did somewhere. Yeah, there. Mine is a much better roll anyway, a lot more health. Same defensive ability, more armor absorption though. Reduced stun duration is 19 and 19. 15 and 15. 24. 24. Yeah, the other one's better. I do need to clear out my inventory, definitely. Oh, you probably were wondering, what the hell is this thing? Well, that's the, if you were a person that, I'm not good at explaining things, go look it up. It's an illusion beacon. It's basically if you bought the special pack for Grimdawn when it was in its infancy, you could buy all these illusions, like the illusion powdered wig and the wisp. And from Corey, the person, I'll show you, just give me a second. This person over here, Corey the Keeper, and yeah. They don't do anything, it's just there. It's a Kickstarter medal or something like that. I can't remember. I don't have it, so I don't really know or care. Anyway. Let's go meet Captain Whiskey Bourbon. Since you already saw my normal playthrough of this, I'm gonna be quick in doing the elite and ultimate, but I'm not gonna rush, of course. Haste makes waste, and I definitely need to grind and bang out a lot of levels and all sorts of stuff. I need to get my reputation up, I need more crystals, I only have three. I need better gear, I need the weapon, I need everything basically. Crimson banging down, very nice. Alright, okay, there was a shrine in the Foggy Bank. I'm not sure if that's an elite either. Again, I'm not good with remembering anything pertaining to shrines and a lot of other things. I mean, if you remind me of something, then yeah, I might just remember it. Might. My memory is just absolutely horrible, so don't ever quote me on anything. Like, I am just the worst. You're gonna have to bear with me. My old saying, bear with me, please. My offensive ability isn't the best either. I definitely need to get that up. But that'll come in due time when I get my lizard and then one into Chaos Crossroad and then start getting into the Dying God, which will enable me to get quite a bit of offensive ability, I'm pretty sure. If I remember correctly, it has a good bit of offensive ability on it. Plus, I probably need to get gear with offensive ability on it and other crap like that. But again, that's all in due time. It's a pipe dream for now. Yeah, offensive ability is 40, plus 3%, plus 45 more. You see what I'm getting at here? It's crazy. And then some chaos damage, which will convert into aether damage once I get the two Aldrich duality. Of course, this is self-found, so I'm not gonna get gear from anyone or anywhere for my stash or anything like that. The only thing I'm using is are the materials from the stash, the components and stuff. Since I can't, like, just keep track of all the components that I found on this character. I mean, I could put them in a separate inventory page, but whatever. I'm not gonna go collecting a million different materials that I already have at my disposal again, and I don't want to collect them again, so you guys understand, I guess. Stupid microphone. I hope it wasn't muted this whole time. I really hope it was, and I don't think it was. Anyway. Moving on. I want to do some side areas now since we are in a lead, and I want to do some side areas, honestly. Do I have any slit necklaces? I do. Is it worth getting the slit necklace quest done? I think it is. I'll get some experience from it as well. I don't know how many we need. I think it's like three, but I can't remember. Some rover reputation. That's not a bad ring, honestly. I like that. It's better than what we have, though, is the question. It is the question. Better, better. More. Less. I think I'll equip it over the resistant diamond signet of protection. Reason being is because it does give 20 elemental resistance, and that's all elemental resistance. It gives less fire resistance by 6 and poison and acid by 6. It gives less defensive ability, but really, who cares? More damage to beastkin, and it's all elemental resistance. It sounds a lot better, honestly. And it has less all damage, so I'll miss out on a little bit of DPS, but it's, in my opinion, it's better, honestly, and it gives some vitality res, which is just fine for me. I definitely need vitality res. If you don't know what res stands for, it stands for resistance. You can also say res with a Z, and that means resurrection in gamer speak. Did not mean to press my oh shit button there. But whatever, got the job done. Milton Heart is dead for good now. And like I said, we're gonna be taking out Blade Arc eventually. I just have to get the Obsidian Juggernaut, which is like a what, a level 75 item if I remember correctly. And I will be taking out the Falcon to get more devotion points in so I can do a few other things. But that, again, will come later. I want to try and get this, try, but I don't think I can. I think all I can get is the Dying God. I don't think I'll have enough points. I'll ask people around if there's a way that I can do both, but I really don't think I can. Like I said, I'm constricted for time, so gotta rush and hurry up. I'm just gonna check the time real quick, 1 second. 9:51. We've been recording for about 12 minutes now or so. By 10 o'clock is probably when I should go, probably 10:10 or something like that. I don't wanna make this too long of an episode again, like I always say, because time constraints and also, the upload time and everything would take quite a while if I made it longer than 10 to 20 minutes. Sometimes I do longer than 20 minutes, but again, I don't have a timer. Like I'm always saying, I don't have a timer for this, and constantly forgot to set up a timer when I start recording, but it's okay. I know I repeat myself a lot, and I know I'm not that smart, but I try my best, you know? Work with what you have. You know, guys, I have autism, I have Asperger's, I have cerebral palsy, I have a lot of things wrong with me, but through it all, I always see the positives in everything. I mean, that's all you can ever do is just see the positives, and don't look at the negatives. That's all you really can ever do in life, is just look at the positives and stick to it. I really don't like seeing people get depressed over what they have. Oh, I have schizophrenia. Let me just get depressed, soul F. No, don't get depressed. Laugh at it. I laugh at my disabilities all the time because that's what you should do. You should laugh in the face of your disabilities and say, hey, I'm stronger than that. I can do anything I feel like it. I can put my mind to something and I can do it. And that's how you should look at it. I laugh at my disabilities because I really just don't feel like there's any point. Well, there's nothing, like, you shouldn't just get mad or anything over what you have. I'm happy to be who I am, and that's all there is to it. In high school, I used to get made fun of all the time. I used to, like, I used to, if you don't know what pinging is, pinging, it's basically when I scream like really loudly in a high-pitched voice, That's me getting very excited, or me getting scared or something like that. I can't really explain it. I'm not even aware that I'm doing it most of the time, and even when I am, I get very embarrassed, and people laugh at me constantly, and it was just really sad. Like, I remember in my English class, people used to be like, "Hey, look at that Brandon kid. Oh my god, he's so stupid." And I was just like, "Yeah, well, let me see your grades. Yeah, well, let me see what they got. I want to tell you something. They got a, So they got what, a 65 or a 66, just barely passing on their English final, and they were happy with that. I looked at them and I was just like, you guys are pathetic. I got a 97 on my English final. One question wrong. One question wrong. The autistic kid. One question wrong." And they just looked at me like, am I stupid? Like, they were literally, they went up to me and they said, "Why are you cheating? How did you get that high?" I'm just like, because I'm a smart person and English is a very easy subject in my opinion. All you have to do is just read the passages and just, take all the details out and rip it apart and look at it that way. I mean, it's simple as all hell to me. All you have to do is just read the passage. All the answers are right there in front of you. I wish I could go back and see which question I got wrong, but that'll never happen, sadly. But it is what it is, and I really couldn't care less. Honestly, people can be just very, very harsh, 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 They really can just be very mean to other people with disabilities just like me. And it's a sad, sad world that we live in, where people just make fun of others like that. I know I'm just rambling on a little bit, but it makes me want to cry because it's just really sad. I hate being made fun of, and I'm glad I have you guys. You guys are very nice to me, which is a nice thing, Well, of course it's a nice thing, you guys are nice to me. But yeah, you guys are always nice to me, and you never make fun of me. I've never seen anyone write a bad comment to me saying, "Ha ha, whatever, you're retarded, bah." No, nothing like that. I'm glad that all of you guys are very understanding of me. At least I think you are. It's sad. People just don't understand autism. They think that you're autistic and they look at you like you have three heads, like why are you in a general ed class? Well, let me tell you a little bit about me. I used to have a teacher aide, an assistant called a para, P-A-R-A, para, and I used to have a bad para. She wasn't good. Like, she wouldn't help me, guide me on my mistakes. Like, she wouldn't correct me, and then everything changed. A very nice male para, M-A-L-E, male para, a man, he was very nice. His name was Mr. Miranda, Wayne Miranda. He was extremely nice to me. He used to yell at me when I was bad. He used to scold me when I was bad. He used to yell at all the time at me. I tried to correct my mistakes. He would be very nice to me. He could be very strict and stern, but very, very nice to me at the same time. Whenever I did something good, he would go up to me and pat me on the back and say, "Good job, Brandon. You know what, Brandon? I'm gonna get you into general ed class. I'm going to make sure that your life moves ahead." And you know what he did? He did just that. He went right up to the office and he requested that I go into co-ed. And then move up from there into general ed. Co-ed is when you have two teachers instead of one, and it's a step behind general ed. General ed is where you have one teacher or for a huge classroom of people. Now, let me tell you something. Once I got into general and co-ed, at first co-ed, then general ed, I was so nervous and scared. I didn't know what to do. I was very nervous, and I was just like, wow, my life is all different now. I don't know what I'm doing. Seriously, it was so confusing and scary. And Yeah, I was just, it was insane. I loved it. It was just something different. I was always used to being in freaking, in the disability classrooms and that kind of crap. What was it called again? And I don't even remember. I know I just said it, but I used to, oh yeah, special ed, sorry. Yeah, I used to be in special ed all the time, and that's what I was used to, just a few kids in the classroom, and they were all bad behavior, and I guess that bad behavior rubbed off on me, and yeah, that's basically it. It was just like that all the time. I was a very bad kid all of my life, even with medication and everything, because I have disabilities, I have to take ADHD medication and antipsychotic medication and that kind of crap. But anyway, so yeah, I used to be a very bad behaved kid. I used to curse a lot. I used to do all sorts of terrible things. I used to hate my teachers. I used to just, well, that was when I was younger, but I was just terrible. I was an absolutely awful kid, and like, you probably wouldn't believe me, but I really was. I was just absolutely a nightmare to deal with. I was just awful. I'm looking back at it and I'm just like, damn, I was just an absolute freaking asshole. Seriously, I was just terrible. And I'm looking back at it and it's just like, damn, what could I have done differently? I mean, my high school average in total, like, I'm gonna tell you right now, my total high school average was like a 94 or 91 or something around that, my full high school average of all of my grades. Guess what? If I had done better in ninth grade when I was just terrible and everything, I could have done so much more with my life. I could have gotten that score and I could have gotten it much higher. You know? I could have gotten such a higher, such a much higher grade, and it just never came to pass because I didn't have a good para that pushed me beyond my boundaries, beyond my limits. He didn't push, like, my old para didn't push me like that. My old para couldn't give a damn less what I did. And guess what? Once that male para, Mr. Miranda, came along, I loved it. He was like, I hated him at first. I really, truly hated him, and he was like, I always thought that he was such an asshole to me, and I was just like, why is this guy such a dick to me? And it, like, and then you look back at it, and it's just like, he was never an asshole. He was never a dick to me. He was nice to me. He was stern but strict, and he was kind at the same time. He was only like that to me because I was like that to him. He was treating me how I was treating him. I was being the worst freaking D-bag in the entire world, and guess what? I was being treated just like that. Treat others how you like to be treated is what I always say now because of that, and I go by that saying because I was a total asshole to him at first. And then once I began to understand him, I started being nicer to him, and I started being nicer to everyone around me. I started looking at it, and I'm sorry, I'm getting a little bit emotional, but I'm just really glad he came along into my life. Thank you, Mr. Miranda, for everything that you've done to me, for me. And I hope that you live for many more years. Thank you for everything. And I know that you probably won't watch this, but I just want to know that I just want you to know that I'm very grateful for all that you've done. And thank you for everything. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see more from my channel. And I'll see you guys later. Have a great day, have a great night. Friends channel in the description down below. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see more from my channel. And I'll see you guys then. I'm sorry, I'm crying a little bit because I'm very, like, I'm an emotional kid. I have many disabilities, including a mood disorder. So getting emotional is nothing like different for me, nothing bad. I'll see you guys later. I hope this little chat was enlightening for you, and I hope that you learned a little bit about me. So I'll see you guys then. Bye, everyone.